Thank you everyone for coming out today on this cold day. I'm so excited to be here. My name is Sarah Woodgate and I'm the director of Calgary Housing. I also have a dual role and I'm the president of Calgary Housing Company as well. I'm delighted to be here to welcome everyone and recognize the grand opening of the new affordable housing development in the community of Wildwood. I'm honored to also welcome Minister Lori Sigurdson from the Ministry of Seniors and Housing, Mayor Nahad Nenshi, Councillor Evan Woolley from Ward 8, as well as MLA Deborah Driver. This development supports the City of Calgary's affordable housing strategy that we call Foundations for Home, and we're focused on increasing the supply of affordable housing for individuals and families living on low and moderate income. It's a beautiful new development of stacked townhomes with 48 new rental homes, including studios, 1, 2, and 3 bedroom units for families. There are almost 100 Calgarians living in this building, and we've been very excited to be occupying it. The total budget was $10.9 million, and I'm pleased to say that the project was completed under budget. Developments like this that we're celebrating today simply would not be possible without the support from funding partners. Funding to build this development was provided by the provincial government. It was a significant commitment. $4.4 million of Housing Capital Initiative funding, $4.9 million in municipal funding through the Municipal Sustainability Initiative, and $1.5 million in Affordable Housing Program municipal block funding. There was also seed money for the project that was provided by Canada Mortgage and Housing Corporation. I really am excited to thank the strong leadership of the Government of Alberta and Calgary City Council today for ensuring that affordable housing remains a priority in our city. This is the fourth opening for the city in the last 2 years, with Kingsland, Crescent Heights, and Bridgeland developments also. These much-needed homes would not be possible without the support of the federal and provincial governments. Groundbreaking for this event happened in May 2017, and it was completed in 2018 September. We had a snowstorm, and so we tried our weather luck, and now it's cold out. But we're really excited about the progress and the ability to achieve in 16 months these new homes. The development will be managed by a Calgary Housing Company who manages 10,000 housing units for 25,000 Calgarians, and it's based on a mixed income model. I would really like to thank the project team and my colleagues at the City of Calgary, as well as our partners, Noor Architects and Ellis Don Construction. The building looks fantastic. And more importantly, I want you to know that you have helped make a real difference in the lives of Calgarians. Housing is about bricks and mortar. However, affordable housing is so important and it's so much more than bricks and mortar. It's about changing lives. Home creates the foundation for people to thrive. One resident of affordable housing has put it that affordable housing has given me peace for my kids, peace for me, and a chance to move forward. And that means a whole lot to me, like you never know. We have a few other stories about affordable housing at the entrance here that you're able to take a look at, and they're also available online on the city website. One reason we're going to tour a single one-bedroom unit today is because the building is full. We started leasing in October, and with that large snowfall that we had at the opening, we had to change our plans. And since that time, the building has been leased. And so it now provides homes to Calgarians. I'd like to invite Lori Sigurdson from the Ministry of Seniors and Housing, the Minister of Seniors and Housing, to say a few words. And I also would, before you come up, just really like to thank the tremendous support with your leadership on the provincial affordable housing strategy and being able to translate that into homes for Albertans.
Thank you, Sarah. Well, thank you so much, Sarah. Good afternoon, everyone. It's certainly my pleasure to join you today on Treaty 7 land, and also I'm proud to acknowledge the Métis people of our province who share a deep connection with this land. It's a pleasure to bring greetings on behalf of Premier Rachel Notley and my government colleagues. And friends, today is a great day here in Calgary. I'm thrilled to be here to celebrate affordable housing in Wildwood. And I'm so pleased to be here with MLA Deborah Driver. And in 2019, when the boundaries change, this affordable housing project will be in her riding. Currently, it's in Minister Malkinson's riding, who unfortunately couldn't be with us today, but we're excited to have MLA Drever here. And of course, Mayor Nenshi and Councillor Woolley and Sarah, so wonderful to be here in Calgary with all of you. Thank you for the City of Calgary for making all this possible. Today, we're here to celebrate the grand opening of the Wildwood Affordable Housing Development. Getting this facility built was a long time coming, but it was a priority for our government to deliver on our promises that previous governments couldn't deliver on. Our government and our Premier, Rachel Notley, were so pleased to support this project, nearly $11 million in funding. We knew what this project would mean to this community and to Calgarians who need safe and affordable housing. The Wildwood Affordable Housing Development is more than just a building, it's a home. And already 47 families have moved into their new homes. Let's clap for that. Our government knows that having a place to live is not a nice to have. Having somewhere to call home is the foundation for a better life. This vision is at the heart of Alberta's first ever provincial affordable housing strategy. Our strategy committed $1.2 billion to build and restore affordable housing. That includes more than 4,100 new and renovated homes for seniors and Albertans with low income. With more than 1,300 units now complete and more than 2,700 in progress, we are well on our way to meeting our goal of 4,100 of new and regenerated homes. This proves that our vision for Alberta is working. Thank you so much for inviting me here today for this special event. It's wonderful to see so many folks out here and to see this project become a reality and for 47 families in Calgary already to have a home. And we have one more unit that needs to be filled, and I know that's going to happen soon. Thank you to both the City of Calgary and the Calgary Housing Company, their enduring commitment to supporting Calgarians in need. The Wildwood Affordable Housing Development is an impressive step forward, making affordable housing more available to Calgarians, and our government is committed to building on this momentum. I look forward to touring the unit to see all the hard work that went into this project since groundbreaking in 2017. I'm so pleased to welcome all those families home. Thank you.
Well, thanks so much, Minister Sigurdson, and thank you all so much for being here today. It's an important day. By the way, I'm still laughing at the fact that in September we thought it was a bit too cold to have this event, so someone thought postponing it to February would be a good idea. But we are celebrating something very important today, but also reminding ourselves of why this is so important. Every single person in our community deserves a decent place to live. Every single person in our community deserves to live a life of dignity. Every single person in our community deserves to live a life without fear. And that's really what we're building when we build affordable housing and when we build affordable housing in this place. We're building communities for everyone, a community where everyone feels safe, everyone feels comfortable, and everyone can achieve the best possible life for themselves and for their families. When safe, affordable housing is available, we're able to help address so many of the major problems in our community, not just homelessness, but we can provide secure refuge for those fleeing domestic violence. We can create safe spaces for those who need a place to restart their lives. We can provide homes where families can establish themselves, where kids can grow, and where the family can move forward in life. This is important stuff, and it makes a huge difference. So today, while we celebrate 48 new units, 47 families, 48 new units. I want to remind us that there are 90,000 of our neighbors here in Calgary who are struggling with housing costs. They're earning less than $60,000 per year, and they're paying more than 30% of their income on shelter. 42,000 of our neighbors, 42,000 households, in fact, more of that than our neighbors, 42,000 households pay more than half of their annual income for housing. 21% of households don't have enough money to purchase a starter home. That's why developments like this are so important and so key to making Calgary a great place to make a living and a great place to make a life. People who have stability in housing, people who have decent places to live, have greater chances to find and keep jobs, to learn, to build skills, to be active participants in their community. Building affordable housing creates local jobs, but more important than that, it helps boost the local economy by strengthening residents' purchasing power, by attracting employers with the promise of a stable workforce. It helps keep vulnerable citizens off the streets. That reduces demand and pressure on emergency services, hospitals, and correction facilities. We know that providing housing for one homeless person saves the system over $34,000 a year. This is a lot of facts. What it means is that the social and financial benefits of affordable housing are clear and important, not just for the people lucky enough to live there, but for all of us. I have to tell you, there's a long way to go. Calgary has the lowest amount of affordable housing compared to all of Canada's big cities. We're opening 48 units today. In order to reach the national average, we need to build 15,000 more. Step by step by step by step, friends. But the steps need to be bigger and there need to be more of them. The last few years have been an incredibly busy time for affordable housing. After more than a decade of, frankly, neglect of this file from provincial and federal governments of all stripes, stepping back from their commitment to make sure every citizen is housed, we've had a lot of move forward, both by the federal government and particularly by this provincial government. The leadership of Minister Sigurdson has made a huge difference on creating that first ever province-wide affordable housing strategy. You may stop at this moment and go, first ever? First ever. But this stuff matters. It makes a big difference. And I know that we'll be working with the federal government and our partners in the federal government as well. I know there's a bilateral agreement coming soon. Right, Minister? Fingers crossed. Doesn't matter that we're late in the game. I like Canadian football. You can win in the last quarter. You can win on the last play. And so don't talk about the Stampeders losing on the last play ever if you want to be my friend. We have an opportunity to make a huge difference, because today what we're doing is we're celebrating giving opportunity to people who felt like they didn't have any opportunity. We're making good on the promise that this is a community for everyone. That's why this matters. I want to say a special thank you to the Government of Alberta. I want to say thank you in absentia to the Government of Canada for their work on this file. I really feel things are moving forward in a big way. You're about to hear from my colleague, Councillor Woolley, but I want to thank him. It has not been easy to be a community advocate for affordable housing. It's not always an easy task, and he is never, ever shy about doing that. And I want to say a particular thank you to my colleagues at the City of Calgary, in Calgary Housing, and at the Calgary Housing Company for their unfailing commitment to this work. I notice you're still hanging out there, Ms. Goldstein. So this is my excuse to say a particular thank you to Teresa Goldstein, who's moving on to other great roles in the city, but who has lived and breathed and built housing for the last few years. Thank you. And a special thank you to our colleagues who actually built the stuff. I think it's important when we open new events to remember that there were women and men with strong backs and great skills, working in all kinds of weather, physically building this project. And I love nothing more than talking to the crews on these projects. And when they say to me, you know, this is so special, I build houses all the time, but now I know I'm really building a community. And I think that is an incredible thing. So thank you to everyone who's been involved, and congratulations to all of those who are gonna have a wonderful new home. I'll turn it over to Councillor Woolley.
Thanks so much for having me out here today. I did just want to thank a couple of people particularly. We are being hosted in the Beaucliff Seniors Building. I know John Yanistis is in the back there. Thank you, John, for hosting us. John's also involved with the Greek community. When I first was elected, I didn't realize how much of the Greek community I was going to represent. And so I just really appreciate you having us in your space here. Where the green room is where some of the old Greek seniors play cards. On Saturdays or Sundays, John?
Every day.
I just also wanted to thank Desmond Bleak. Des was the file manager on this. This is, well, the construction went unbelievably smoothly darn dry cleaners. There was a dry cleaner across Blow Trail that really caused a lot of the problems in terms of timing. Thanks, Des, for all of your hard work. This was not not without its challenges. I also just noticed Tara is here. Tara works at Shaganapi Village. Shaganapi Village is just right beside the project that we're building now. So I've been involved in this neighborhood for many years. My mom's midlife crisis was after she owned a daycare center for 20 years was to buy a little cafe that was in the strip mall here called the Blue Spruce Cafe. And as like a 17-year-old getting to make as many Monte Cristos on this like crazy big grill was really, really unbelievable.
That was like 2 years ago?
This is one of the, so what's interesting, and we've talked a lot, you know, these aren't just houses we're building homes, but we're also rebuilding a community up here. And this is a community that has some of our deepest, our largest amount of social housing, so deep subsidy housing. And as we've been rebuilding this community, we've been thinking about everybody in the community. A lot of the kids at Shaganapi Village play basketball here. They tore down the old Beaucliff Seniors and built this one. And as they were building it, one of the complaints from the kids playing basketball was they had no place to get water. So they piped in water fountains for them. Right at Shaganapi Village, one of our old pedestrian overpasses has reached life cycle. And so we are now building an overpass that better suits the pedestrians that live in that building. Wildflower Art Center, which is right here, is doing classes for people in this community. This is a wonderful place, not just for the homes that we're building, but for the community that we're rebuilding. And I think that that's really, really important for us. It's funny, a lot of people who oppose affordable housing say, why would we put them on all of this really prime real estate? Why would we put affordable housing on prime real estate? And we particularly do it because it allows people to access all of the services that they need. And this particular geographic location is unbelievably suited to have affordable housing in it. And we're building a different model. We are not building the models that they built in the past that we know were unsuccessful, that we know were not successful. We're building a new model of affordable housing where people can live more seamlessly within their communities. And I'm just really, really thankful and lucky to have been a part of this. Minister Malkinson, and while you are maybe the future MLA, Minister Malkinson has spent an extraordinary amount of time in this community. And I'm saying one of the most awkward dancing moments I've ever had, Your Worship, was during Greek Fest when the DJ play, you have to hold hands and spin around the circle. And I remember Minister Malkinson and the mayor and I going, good God, when will this end? John, maximum 4 minutes. Maximum 4 minutes. But I really, really do appreciate everybody's hard work in building this to fruition. We are building homes for people and we're building a community, and I just feel really, really honored to be able to be a part of that. So to the provincial government and the mayor and Calgary Housing Company, I just really, really thank you from the bottom of my heart. So thank you.